Hi guys, and welcome to your channel. Another very exciting video tutorial for Adobe Premiere Pro, and in this tutorial we will be talking about color correction. Okay, and now in this first tutorial about color correction, you know, I will talk to you what is the importance of color correction, and also what things to keep in mind when you are correcting the color of your video clip or image that is in your project. Okay, first of all, a color correction might be a daunting task. It might sound like that because most of the people or us do not dwell into color theory and color correction that much. The other stuff in the Premiere Pro or the effects, you might have played with them in other softwares also, but color correction is something only the professional goes into, and it is a very important part of video post-production process. And I'm not gonna teach you like a professional has been taught about color correction, all the nitty-gritty detail. I'm just gonna tell you about the standard stuff, you know, that you can keep in mind, only the six basic principles of color correction and how you can improve the color of your video. And almost 9 out of 10 times, even a good professional would not be able to tell that whether it is a mature person has done the color correction or a professional person has done. If you can follow my, you know, color correction process or tutorials correctly. And secondly, if you cannot even follow those six principles that I'm telling you, I'm gonna teach you a very good effect inside Premiere Pro that is built in, that you can apply and automatically improve the color of your pictures. Now I want to say something before correcting the color of these pictures, that the color of this picture is already very correct, you know. In order to demonstrate this tutorial or this point clearly, I should have gone to the Google and downloaded a really bad color, you know, pictures, or taken some crappy pictures with my phone. But since I am so lazy, I was unable to do that in the daytime, and now it's nighttime and I don't want to go outside the house, and it's not that I'm afraid, I'm online, as you can see. But my camera is so bad that at night time its pictures are even worse than, you know, it would be so much ruined, or the picture would be so bad that even Premiere Pro could not correct the colors or stuff like that. Okay, first of all, let us talk about the six principles that, or the six main points that you should always keep in mind while color correcting any picture or any video clip. The first one is that you should always look at the black and the first and second one. Okay, these are, I'm gonna tell you together, the black and the white parts of the picture. You know, the black parts here in its this line here, the shadows on this bark of the tree, if they are black, then they should be 100% black. And if some place in this background it's white, its mouth area is white, okay, or there is a wall somewhere in the picture or in your video clip, its color is white, then it should be white. A white should be always white, and a black should be always black. That is the first principle that you should always keep in mind, that before doing anything else to your picture, make sure that the whites of your picture or video clip are white and they are not bluish, orangish or grayish in color, and the blacks are always black, they are not dull in color. So those are the first two principles. Actually, if you can count them as one, that is also correct, but suppose they are two principles, because black and white are two different things. Okay, the second thing is that you should always look at the brightness. How bright your picture is. Is it too bright? Is it making it flat? Or is it too dark and there is nothing to see in the picture? Okay, so the second one, or the third one, is brightness. The fourth one, or the fourth principle that you should keep in mind, is the contrast. That every should the thing in the picture should be different from the other things in that picture. So suppose this book or these leaves, they should be fully distinguishable their boundary lines from the environment they are lying. Or this line, its boundary line or its body parts should be totally contrasted from the environment they are lying. A good bare contrast picture would be like this, that you would be unable to easily detect what is the body part of the lion and what is the dirt lying on the ground. So that's the fourth principle. And the fifth principle is the color cast. Sometimes a picture has a color cast, you know, it has some sort of tint applied on all parts of it. You know, for example, if it's someone want to give it a cool color, you know, they throw in a little bit of bluish tint over it, or if someone to give it a warm color, then you throw orangish color or tint over it and stuff like that. You know, you should always keep that in mind, and also not to, you know, change or overdo that color cast of the picture. The sixth principle that you should keep in mind is the saturation level of color. You know, saturation refers to the meaning in this color correction sense, is that how much colors are there in your picture. The level is either too flat or either the color are too intense and it becomes unnatural to see. So keep these things in mind: the black and whites, the contrast, the brightness, the color cast, and the saturation level. I think there are five principles if you count it, or maybe 16 principles. Well, it depends on your counting. But these are the most important things to keep in mind while color correcting your pictures. Okay, but if you can't even mind or keep or correct even these six or five things, then there is a very neat effect in you know, Premiere Pro. Just go to the effects and in the search bar write color, and it will bring up all these color effects. You know, there are so many of them in here. You know, you should really play with them to, you know, get a feel for it and get you know, to know how each one is applied correctly. But the one that is most useful to a novice, a person who does not know even squat about colors, is this one under the obsolete folder, the auto color. You know, if you apply this, it does almost I would say 70 or 80% good job, you know, that a professional would do for your picture. Just grab it and put it on the picture, and as I put it on the picture, look at the picture of the lion, how much it changes. As you can see, how much just applying this one simple color effect on it, it's automatically improved it. You do not have to change any parameters around here, although it has a lot of parameters this effect has. You do not need to do anything in here. You just apply it and it improved it so much. The leaves, the greens of it, the contrast, the whites and the black, the saturation level, the contrast level, the brightness level, all the things that I discussed earlier on that you should at least keep in mind. Just by applying this auto fixed color, you know, auto color effect, it improved them all and corrected them all. So, but there might come time when your picture are so ruined that auto color might not work for them. Then there are some other tricks I would be telling you about them in the upcoming tutorials, and they are not that difficult also to master. And the main thing, as I always say, watching and learning about or reading about an effect or a technique in Premiere Pro is nothing if you do not practice it. Okay, the more you practice, the more you will become natural or apt at that technique. So let's turn off this effect once more. As you can see, the picture is very flat and very dull in its looking, in contrast and brightness, and everything is really bad. Okay, as we turn the effect on, it has made it significantly better. So in this first tutorial, that's it guys. I just wanted to talk about the principles that you should keep in mind, the main principles of color correction. In the upcoming tutorial, we will be talking some more about the color correction. Until the next tutorial, goodbye.